Okay, so we're gonna be on the floor, yellow band at least. Yellow or red, put it around your feet like that. So we're gonna do a whole series of stuff with the band on the floor. So we'll be here for just a minute. Rolling back all the way, legs tabletop. Flexing through the feet, turn to an angle. Keeping your knees, heels in line, you're gonna push out with your feet and release. Push out, release. Anchor your tailbone. We're not imprinting down on the ground. Press out. And obviously you wanna open as wide as you can, tiny little hold before you release. Ribs are closed, shoulders down. Five, four, three, two. Now hold your feet as wide as you can. We're gonna lower down the heels and up. You don't have to go all the way down to touch the floor, but make sure you're pushing. Use the hips all the way down the outside of the leg. If you're going down toward the floor, engage that lower belly. You can feel when it locks in. Keep your middle and upper back pressed into the floor. Last one. Good, we meet up here. From that external position, push out, 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 out. Trying to stay as wide as possible. Ribs are down, neck is long. Five, four, three, two, and one. Release in, good. Right leg comes tabletop, left leg extends, pushing through that band. So you want to pull that right leg forward and then switch. Now tip your lower back into the ground. So we're imprinting. Marching in place. Keep tension on that band. Let's do four more each side. Belly's down, ribs down, neck is long. Pushing through that heel. Three more each side. Two. Keep that lower back pressed now. And last one. Let's end up with our left knee forward. Exhale. Upper body curls up. Pull that knee in, in, in. Tipping the pelvis up to the sky, imprinting the lower back. Four, three, two. Switch legs, upper body down. Exhale, come back up. Pull in, in, in. Five, four, three, two. Now keep your upper body up there and march in place. Exhale, deepen that contraction. Pull that knee forward, extend that straight leg. Alternate. Take your time. Lifting your shoulder blades off the ground. Don't crunch your elbows toward the front. Keep them wide. Do four more each side. Three. Two. And last one each side. And let's bring it in. Knees to the chest. Alrighty, that is a workout for your hip flexors and your abdominals. Let's work that band up above our knees. Come back into the tabletop position, pointing through the toes this time, and go as wide as you can. Control in. Opening the knees. Now imprint your lower back. As you open, deepen that imprint. Let's do five more.
four, three, two. And this time, knees are as wide as you can hold it. Lengthen the legs, bend it. Lengthen, you have to deepen that secret or the imprint, sorry. Four. Three. Shoulders down, long neck. Two. And one. Long legs. Come up toward 90. Open into a V, push into that band, and come back in. Not all the way, but keep tension on the band. Opening. And in. Open. Six. Five. Press your lower back in, close those ribs, lengthen through the neck. Good. Open into that V. Nice deep breath. Hands go in between your thighs underneath the band. Exhale, curl your upper body up. Little lifts for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. And bring it in. Keep the band right where it is. We're gonna put our feet on the ground. Nice wide stance so there's tension on the band. Imprint. Press that lower back bra strap into the ground. Exhale, fingertips forward, chin to the chest. We're rolling up, keeping your feet planted. Pressing out on that band, coming all the way up. Roll back down, C curve. Arms up overhead. Fingertips forward, roll. Let's do two more like this. Nice long spine, long breath. And last one. Keep your arms high. We roll down, fingertips forward and up. Four more. Take your time, plant your feet. Keep external pressure on that band. Last two. And last one. Good, stay laying down. Draw your feet closer. Bring the insides of your arches together. Plant your feet. Press out in a little butterfly. Slowly release, just about 2 to 3 inches. Press out, hold. Slow release. Press out, hold. Slow release. Four. Three. Hold your knees wide, lift your heels, little press out and out. Squeeze your heels together. Eight, seven, six. Ribs down, long neck. Last two. And last one, hold your knees wide, heels stay lifted. Peel your lower back off the mat. Come into your bridge. Roll down, keeping your heels squeezed together and lifted, knees wide. Again, all the way to neutral. Exhale, imprint, scoop, come up into bridge. Two more. Exhale, shoulders down. Articulate the vertebrae as they lay back down. Articulate as you peel up. Good, let's meet up and bridge here. Little butterfly, open, open. Keep those hips lifted. Ribs closed. Shoulders down. 8, 7, 6. Squeeze those heels together. Keep them lifted. 4. Breathing. Last 2. And last 1. Stay wide. Double time. Press, 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 press. 8, 7. Keep the hips lifted. 4, 3, 2. Little tailbone taps. Tap and lift. Keep the knees wide. Lift. Tap and lift. Heels squeeze together. Stay lifted. 5, 4. Good. Last one. Hold it here. Last little butterfly. Open. Lift the pelvis. Open. Lift the pelvis. Open. Lift. Open. Lift. 6. Shoulders down. Ribs are closed. Jaws relaxed. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Knees are wide. Articulate vertebra by vertebra. Rolling down. Good. Bring the knees to the chest. Happy baby. Good. Release. Let's take the band off. Put it around the bottom of your right foot. Left leg is on the ground. Draw that right leg in. Now pull that right hip out of your rib cage. Drop that right hip. Lengthen through the neck. We're going to externally rotate in your right leg just so you open a little to the side. Keeping that left butt cheek on the ground. Keeping that left heel in line with the hip. Come back parallel. Holding that leg in, reach through the foot, exhale, upper body curls up, lift that left foot off the ground, imprint your back, scoop, scoop, scoop the pelvic bone up to the sky, and little bend, flex, lengthen, point, bend, flex, lengthen, point, 2 more, bend, flex, last one. Good. Upper body lays down. Left heel goes in. One last pull. Drop your right hip. Good. Take your foot out. Float that leg down. Let's switch. Left leg in that strap. Drop that hip down out of your rib cage. Pull that leg in. Anchor your tailbone, extend through that right leg. Externally rotate the left hip socket and open to the side. Closing the ribs, shoulders down, neck is long. Come back parallel, point through the toes. Exhale, upper body reaches up, lifting that right heel. Imprint your lower back, scoop that pelvic bone up to the sky. Little bend, flex, point, lengthen. Bend, flex, drop that right hip out of the rib cage. 2 more. Last one. Upper body down, right heel down, draw that leg in one last time. Good. And release the leg. Alrighty. Scoop, roll up. Before we get on the machine, we're going to do a little upper body with the strap. So you can sit cross-legged or on your knees. You'd be up here like this. Actually, if it's okay, why don't we be up here like this? The band goes around the outside of your hand. Open your fingers. Okay, so you don't start to buckle in. You want to extend through those fingers, nice long arms. Your booty's engaged. Don't jam your hips toward though, right? Stay nice and stacked, shoulders over the hips. Your arms are long. With those spread fingers, you press out and out, out. You should feel your obliques engage. 5, 4, 3, 2. Now hold that external pressure, bend in. Press out, 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 out. Lengthen, bend in. Lengthen, bend in. Lengthen, 4 more. Think of lifting up in the armpit, shoulders pull down, close your ribs. Keep your booty engaged. Last 3, 2, last one. Lengthen, let's lift, not 90 degrees from our body, but 45, press out, out, out. Lift in the sternum, belly pulls in. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, release. Same position with the band, but arms are behind. Lengthen through the fingers, spread your fingers, shoulders roll back. All right, we're gonna sit back ever so slightly in our haunches, so the tops of the feet bear your weight. Pull the belly in, ribs in, upper body's at a diagonal. Lift your arms, shoulders down. Same thing, press out, out, out. Each time you press out, reach your fingertips away from you, further. 8. Last 4, 3, 2. Hold those arms nice and long, lift them 2 inches. Little bend and reach. Bend and reach. Bend. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And last one, lengthen those arms, press out hard, lift 2 inches and lower. Lift and lower. Let's do 6 here, ribs are in, spine is long. Last 3, 2, and last one. And let's bring it up. Beautiful. And remove it. Shake it out. Okay. Let's get on the machine. Let's do a red, yellow, blue. Foot bar is up. Red, yellow, blue. Foot bar up. We're laying down. Headrest is up or down as you wish. Let's change the angle.
A little bit.
Okay. Whoops, sorry. Balls of the feet are on the foot bar. Narrow V. Heels are lifted. All the way out. Okay, neutral spine. Close ribs. Heels are high. Squeeze them together. Halfway in. Exhale, squeeze, lengthen. Halfway in. Squeeze, lengthen. The last 2 inches. Squeeze all the way up. Four. Engage the booty. 3. Ribs heavy. 2. Alrighty, we're gonna bring the carriage in halfway. Hold it there. Heels down, up, down, up. Keep the carriage still. 5, 4, 3, 2. Heels are high, prancing. Right, press. Left, right. 4, 3, 2. Both heels high, squeeze, press all the way out, heels down up. Carriage and out. All the way out, down up. Down up. Don't forget about your booty. Connecting your booty to your heels. Resist that carriage in. Four. Three. Two. Good. We're going to come back. We're going to carriage halfway in. Little out and in. 6-inch range of motion. Out and in. Lift the heels. Squeeze them together. Five. Four. Three. Two. We're going to take the carriage all the way out to close the motion. And bring it in. Good. Shake it out. Great. Balls of the feet on the foot bar, ankles, knees together. Lift the heels high, parallel. Take it all the way out. Engage your booty. Close the ribs. Bring it halfway in. Heels down and up. Down. Tina. And up. Squeeze the ankles together. Five. Four. Tina. Three, two, heels are high, we prance, one and the other. Really walk through that calf, pressing the heel under the bar as far as you can, keeping the carriage still. Three, two, last one, both heels high, all the way out, heels down and up, and in. Squeeze knees together, booty's engaged. Four, three, two, and last one. Bring the carriage in halfway, Tina. Out and in, 6 to 8 inches. Pushing through your big toe, ankles, knees squeeze together, control the carriage. Six, five, four. Breathe in, ribs down, shoulders down, relax the jaw. Take the carriage all the way out to close motion. Heels are still high. And bring it up. Good. Shake it out. Okay. Heels are on the foot bar. Just distance between your knees. Okay. Stop. Stop. There's nothing there. Let's push out. Engage your booty. Neutral spine. Close the ribs. Halfway in. Out and in. Visualize your sit bones squeezing toward one another. Connect your heels with your sit bones. Six, five, four, three. You're going to go all the way out and all the way in. Press all the way straight leg. Squeeze. And in. Exhale, parallel. In, we're going to single leg march, pushing through, 6 times each side, lengthen that leg, three, two, last one each side. And let's meet up halfway in, out and in. 8, 7, push through the heels, connect the heels to the sit bones. 4, 3, 2, close the motion by going all the way out and bring it all the way in. Good. Okay, last thing here, narrow V on our heels. Tina, push all the way out, squeeze, lengthen. Tiny plie at the top, soften, lengthen, soften, lengthen. Booty's engaged, tailbone is anchored, ribs are closed, shoulders down. 8, 7, last two, and last one. Hey, and bring the carriage in. Lift your tailbone, put your hand underneath. That's the height you want to be. Not imprinted and curled or arched. Nice, long, neutral spine. Exhale, press out and in there. Sticky feet, pull that carriage in. Sticky, sticky. All the way, straight legs. Don't start letting your tailbone fly high so you put the work in your lower back. You're hovering just the height of your hand. Let's do 4. Pulling that carriage in. All right, last one. Keeping your tailbone floating. Halfway, out and in, 6 inches, push out and in. Again, don't let that tailbone fly high. Don't put the work in your lower back. Sticky feet, 5, 4, 3, 2. Take it all the way out. Bring it all the way back in. And tailbone down, knees to the chest. Take a little side rock. Good. Heels on the foot bar. We're just going to do a little spiral, holding onto the shoulder blocks or the pegs. Come through the center, other direction. One more time. As you spiral, I'm going to the left. My right leg is going to lengthen. And I come up to center, bend. Spiral to the right. Left leg extends. And come up. Good. Alrighty. Let's roll to the side. Let's go to a single red spring for some single leg work. Laying down, headrest can be up or down. Sorry, let's start on our left foot in the strap. Start tabletop, ankles, knees together, square your hips, ribs down, press the back ribs into the carriage. Flex feet, pushing diagonally 45 degrees through that heel. Come back in, meeting up with your right leg. Five. Last two, make sure your hips don't feel wonky. 45 degrees, extend through the toes, come back toward 90. Point through that right foot now. Only go as far as you can keep the work at that glute hamstring insertion point and without rolling into your back. Two more. And 45 degrees, forward bicycle. Working that that leg in a circle. Don't hyperextend in the knee. Keeping that knee soft as you push forward. Ribs down, three. Last one, 45 degrees, let's reverse. Reverse bicycle pedal, reaching through the toe. Just have to kind of fight with that strap. Good, 45 degrees, left leg. Right leg is to 90. Scissor. Spine, ribs are down, neck is long. Three, two, and going to helicopter from 45 degrees. Helicopter open to scissor, watching that your tailbone stays anchored, your hips are square. Two more times. All the way through. We want to meet up with our left leg, 45. All right, come back tabletop and we're gonna bicycle through. One leg pulls in as the other extends. Don't roll into your lower back though. Push your left leg out, both legs are 45. Externally rotate, flex. Little froggy here. Push through that midline. Let's do four. Three. Two. And one. And bend it in. Stick the foot out, switch sides. Starting tabletop, line up your ankles and knees, neutral spine, close the ribs, square your hips, and press through, flex foot. Make sure you stop in that tabletop. Next 45 degrees, left leg up to 90, and we scissor through. Make sure that right hip doesn't float up into your rib cage. Don't hyperextend on the knee. Long. Don't tumble into your lower back. Three, two, and let's meet up with that left leg tabletop and forward single leg bicycles with your right. Energy out of that left leg. Two more. And last one. We are 45 degrees reverse, backwards pedal. Make sure that you're not tumbling into your lower back here. Two more. Alrighty, push through to 45 degrees. Lengthen out your left leg, externally rotate, flex through the feet. Heels are in line with the center of the pelvis, pushing through. Last one. And let's bring it in. Alrighty. Let's switch to a blue spring. Let's put our foot bar down. Upper body. So let's get the really horrible stuff over first.
Okay.
We're gonna feet are on the platform. We do our plank push-ups. Feet are on the platform, heel of the hand is on the inside of the shoulder block. Okay, we're gonna push out to plank. Oh, no, sorry, I'm so wrong. Forefinger and thumb on either side of the shoulder block I'm talking about. Okay, we push out. Your plank, your pelvis, ribs. Alrighty, let's start pushing forward. Just forward. That exaggerates the plank. You have to pull your belly in. Really engage the pelvic floor. Lifting into that midline. Three. Scoop out the arm and shoulders down. Two. And last one. Okay, remember our plank push-ups. We push forward. Come up. In. Out. And down. Pull in. And out. You're welcome to do one arm at a time. But we're gonna do six. Be honest. That's already three. Two more. Last one. And bring it down, good. Elbows in underneath the shoulders. Hold that plank for eight, seven. And let's pull into our pike. Drop the crown of the head. A yoga handstand. Find your plank each time. Four. Three. Two. And one. Hold that plank. Four, three, two, and one. Coming to a high hip child's pose. Finger, thumb on either side of the shoulder block again, coming into extended arm plank. Shoulders down, long neck, pull the ribs in, tuck the pelvis toward your chin, and we're going to pull the carriage forward as far as you can support. Exhale, pull it in. Four. Balls of our feet, push forward, pull back, adjust the feet, scoop out your armpit, pull the shoulders down, tuck the pelvis, lift the belly, four, three, two, and last one. Let's hold it there. Last four, three, two, and one. High hip child's pose. Alrighty, we're gonna come into all threes or all fours after we have our girls shiner break. Okay, let's start with our right arm. Let's walk our knees back. Left hand is toward the center of the carriage. Long black strap. Okay, so you're toward the right side of your carriage. Sorry, I should have said that. Shoulders down, tabletop back. Sit back into your haunches ever so slightly so you're not pitched forward on your right shoulder. Take the weight off. Sit back into your rear end. Exhale, float that arm close to the body, palm to the sky. Forward. Keeping that contraction, keeping tension on the cable as you return floating back up so you don't have to reinitiate that contraction, you use it. Shoulders down, keep them square. Let's do three. Two. And we're gonna meet up at the top. Elbow stays close to the rib cage. You bend and push through tricep for eight. Square the shoulders, seven. Long neck, breathe. Last four. Two, and last one, and let's bring it in. Good, we're not done. On the same arm, choke up on your hardware. You're gonna pull that elbow back. Nice light hold with your hand. You wanna pull back with that elbow, sitting back in your hips, not crashing in on that left shoulder. Let's do five, square your shoulders, ribs are in, four. And last one, good. Releasing to the top of the cloth, the top of your straps. And extend all the way back, kicking that heel of the hand back. Don't swing it, thrash it, shortchain it. Do five more. Four. And last one. Good. Let's release. Right arm threads through. Let's take that spiral, square your hips. And coming Yep, before you go to the other side, sitting on our knees, arm up behind. Drop that hand, if you can or want, clasp with your left. Open up through the sternum. Now take a little hinge, a little lean to the left. And bring it back up. Beautiful, other side. Still on a blue strap. Take the long black strap in your left hand. Scooch over toward the left side of your carriage. Lengthen through that arm. Now sit back in your haunches and press through. Shoulders down, hips are square, belly's engaged, ribs are closed, neck is long, make sure you're not holding tension in your neck or your jaw. Last two. And that's one, we're gonna meet up. An arm is long, bend through the elbow. The elbow stays close to the rib cage. Six. Punch all the way to the back. Try and straighten your wrist so you really squeeze into the tricep. Last three. Two. And one. Bring it forward. All right, choke up all the way in front of your hardware. Sit back and just pull with that elbow. Light hold on the cable, on the hardware. Five. Four. And last one. And come to the top of the cloth, pull back with the other heel of the hand, squeeze it back. Five, four, and last one, and release. Good. Right, thread that left arm through. Pull the shoulder down away from your ear and try and square your hips so you really open up in the side. And when you're ready, come up. Bend that elbow behind. Back with the right hand, close your ribs. If you lift in the sternum and pull your elbows away from one another. Good. Let's release. Okay, let's come to a red. Foot bar back up. I'm going to start on my right side. So right foot is against the machine, left foot's on the shoulder block. Push back, keeping the knee off. We're going to push back into a lunge. Push into that right heel so your knee is not forward of the heel to start, but it's back. Open through the chest, close the ribs. Now push the carriage back, and we're gonna pitch forward so your knee does come forward and take it back. Find a range of motion where the work is in that quad and not in your lower back. Three, quad and glute, you should feel it. Two, last one. We're gonna meet up pushing that carriage all the way back Bend and reach the left knee, staying low. Four, three, two, and one. Soften the knee, push all the way back and down into your lunge. Walk your right foot forward, come into whatever modified split. Good. Coming forward. Standing up. Standing leg is straight. We're going to go into a cat back. So fingertips are on the foot bar, hollow, scooping round in the belly, pushing through that left foot only as far as you can by maintaining the standing C curve. Push and push. If you notice my hip, my standing leg is at an angle to the heel, so you don't want to be standing right forward top. Push into that heel so your weight is back. Not a big range of motion, it's only about 8 inches. You're pushing that carriage forward and back, controlling it forward, pushing it back, getting right into that glute. Five, four, three, two, and last one. Good, bring it in. We're standing up, same legs, genie arms. We're gonna push back and down both legs. So as this one straightens, as my right straightens, my left bends. As my left reaches long, my right bends. Let's do four. Keep the ribs closed. Gaze is straight ahead, shoulders down, neck is long. Last two. And last one. Yay! Other side. Girls shadow break. Left foot's against the frame. Right foot's on the shoulder block. Okay, come into your cat back. So scoop your pelvis forward, shift your weight into your left heel, hollow up, lengthen and soften through the neck, and we're pushing back. All the way down. Keep that knee floating. Soften and lengthen through that right leg, tapping the knee on the carriage. Keep your weight in your left supporting heel, ribs closed. Three, two, and knees on the carriage, push down into that lunge, walk your left foot forward. Open up through that right hip flexor. Try and square your hips up. Pull the left hip back. And let's come up. Genie arms. Okay, we're pushing back. Alternating. Extension. Bending the legs. Six. Control the carriage. Five. Keeping the hips square, shoulders square. Sternum is lifted while your ribs are closed. Last three. And And one. Alrighty. I feel like we have done something, but I can't think of what it is. How about before we do leg circles, we do a little booty on the floor. So come back to your mat for my favorite. So we're gonna lay down on our tummy on the mat. Forehead goes in your hands. Knees are as wide as you can walk them. Heels squeeze together, pull your heels towards your booty. Flex your feet like somebody's gonna put a tray of champagne glasses there. Looking down, shoulders down. Tuck your pelvis into the floor, lift your belly. Hold that tuck and lift. And then lift your knees off the ground. Press up, up, up. No, down, just up. Don't let your heels float away from your booty. Six, five, four, three. Keep closing the ribs, lifting the belly. Good, double time. Up, 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 up. Tuck the pelvis, lift the belly. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Now double time. Quick. Up, 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 up. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. And bring it down. Good. Sit back. Last set. Forward. Knees are wide. Flex the feet. Pull your heels close to your booty. Now tuck your pelvis, lift your belly, lift the knees. We're going to alternate. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Eight, seven, six, five, four to hold, three and a hold, two, heels together, lift and hold for eight, higher, seven, six, five, higher, higher, last two, and one, and bring it back. While we're here, let's do a little downward dog. Push your heels to the floor. Heels are sit bone distance. Ribs are closed, shoulders are down, neck is long, pressing the chest toward your ankles. Good, walk your right foot toward the center of the pelvis and float your left leg up. Don't pop your ribs, don't lose the shoulders, and bend your left knee, open the pelvis and the hip, without letting those ribs get out of control. Extend back through that leg, come parallel, and float the leg down, switch feet places so your left foot is a little bit centered, float your right leg up, square your hips, shoulders down, ribs are in, and bend that right knee, open your hips. Square the hips, lengthen out that leg. One last press, and bring it down. Ankles, knees, thighs together. Press in your heels to the ground as you reach your chest toward your ankles. Your knees. Let's come forward and let's go to a yellow and a blue. Back on the reformer. So bars up or down, we're laying back, feet are in the long black straps. Thank you. 45 degrees. Reach to your toes, squeeze your ankles, knees together. 90 degrees to 45. Anchor your tailbone, neutral spine, close the ribs. So only go as high as you can stay in neutral spine. Floating up, the energy is pressing down. Three more. Two. And this time, 45 degrees, we bend the knees in, keeping everything together as long as you can, up to 90, and in. And keep those knees together. Next 45 degrees, we're gonna reverse. So we come up to 90, you bend, dolphin dive those feet. You just have to fight with your cables. Keeping the knees and ankles as glued as you can. Three. Next 45 degrees, we start circles at the bottom. Keep that tailbone grounded, neutral spine, ribs are closed, shoulders down. If you ever head rest up, put it down. Next one, next 45 degrees, we'll do long spine. So ankles and knees together. We lift up, start nice and high. Exhale, rolling down. Lifting up. Vertebra by vertebra, rolling down. This time adding on, if you want, we come up. Carriage comes in, you lower down, come back up, find tension in your cables, and roll down, again, come high, float that carriage in, legs down, find tension, roll back down. Good. How about we do a little short spine? Go up nice and high, externally rotate, heels stay together. Carriage still comes in as we roll down. Push through. Hollowing out in the belly. As you roll down, try not to pull your shoulders up to your ears. Use the breath. Let's do one more. Beautiful. Come to 90 degrees. Start circles there. Spine neutral, tailbone is anchored, ribs are down, neck is long, shoulders are soft, jaw is relaxed. Let's do four more. Alrighty, 45 degrees, externally rotate, Peter Pan. Same thing, no tumbling into your lower back. heel of the bent leg comes straight to the pelvis. Two more times each side. Last one. And let's float up to 90. Flex through the feet. When you're ready, release into your extended V, flexing through the heels. Get off your lower back, so tip your pelvis toward that far wall. Good. Before we're done, a little cable assist. Come in 45 externally rotated. You're going to open to it however wide a V to close back. Little inner thigh, sit bone connection closer. Let's do four more. Time 45, let's pull our heels into a butterfly, pull close to the pelvis, and try and soften and release through the hips.